and gentlemen, it is time to meet the wedding party. He is 5 years old and from McPherson, Kansas. His parents are Denise and Chris Lawrence. With two sisters and two brothers, he's great at art and math. When he found out the wedding was in Arkansas, he told his mom he wouldn't have to wear shoes. Please welcome our ring bearer, Benjamin Lawrence. Come on up, Ben. She is from Northwest Arkansas, has a one-year-old brother named Talon. Her parents are Rachel and Sean Rhodes, and she just started gymnastics. Please give a round of applause for Maylee Rhodes. It's okay. This way. It's all right. All right, time for the groomsmen. We'll work on Maylee. This guy is a friend from Graduate Christian Fellowship in Albuquerque. He's almost done earning his PhD in physics, has an unappreciative cat named Squeakers, and once unsuccessfully donated his beard to homeless birds. Please welcome Jonathan Gross. Next up, he's an electrical engineer from Wisconsin. He was Rick's roommate in college and loves to hunt wampus near the rebel base on Hoth. It has to be Benjamin Frederick. Next up, he's a classmate from the University of New Mexico, a Navy veteran, and currently living in New Mexico. And he used to have an afro when he lived on a submarine. Please welcome Nicholas Brechtel. And now the bridesmaid. She's originally from South Korea. She's now living in Colorado with her husband Joseph and an adorable German shepherd named Chewy. I'm noticing a Star Wars theme here. Please say hi to Elisa Choi. Next up, she's from Tokyo, Japan, where she works at a Japanese language school. She met the bride at Arkansas Tech and played softball for 9 years. It was a very long game. Please say hi to Natsuki Uno. And next, a woman with many aliases, Kate Ginger Snap. She lives in Conway with her husband, Daniel. She works for the Arkansas Democrat Gazette. Subscribe today. She met the bride while they were both working at the Lutheran camp at Pettigene. Her favorite coffee flavor is English toffee. And ironically, her favorite toffee flavor is English coffee. Please welcome Catherine McCool. Next up, the best man. He has known the groom all of his life and feels like Rick is a brother to him. He's from Oak Creek, Wisconsin, and works for Rolls-Royce. No, there is not a friends and family discount. He has a reputation for loving waffles, and it says here his forehead has won an egg fight, proving once again comedy is tough. Please welcome our best man, Wade Jackson. Next up, a woman who also goes by the name of Strawberry met the bride while living in La Mesa, California. She lives in Russellville for now and is engaged to John McCauley. She loves ballet, she loves bacon, but not necessarily at the same time. Here's our maid of honor, Laura Cobb. And last but not least, they recently celebrated their 60th minute anniversary. Currently residing in the Crown Plaza in Little Rock, the bride and the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Richard Jackson. Applause for the wedding party. Give it up. photographers, if you're good, wow. Jingle bell, jingle bell. That's it. So now we'll have the bride and groom sit down at their official table. Wedding party back. Well, wait, stay put for a second. We're going to do a prayer real quick. Pastor Basic, this is your cue to come up. Don't stare at him as he comes this way. Make him nervous. Huh?
Thank you.
What do you want me to do with it?
Whatever you want.
Great show. That's a hard act to follow. Please bow your heads with me and pray. Almighty and everlasting God, our Heavenly Father, grant that by your blessing, Richard and Megan may live together according to your word and promise. Strengthen them in faithfulness and love toward each other. Sustain and defend in them every trial and every temptation. Help them to live in faith toward you, in the community of your holy church, and in loving service to each other. That they may ever enjoy your heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now pray the common table prayer together. Come, Lord Jesus, be our guest, and let thy gifts to us be blessed. Amen. Eat up.
Yep. Thanks, bridal party. Thank you.
Thank you. Bravo. Bravo. Aww.
But that's what
that was.
Congratulations, go Cardinals.
You've heard of Minnie Pearl.
Yeah.
Well, she became so famous that she was invited to Dallas one time to make a speech. When she got on the airplane, there was a cowboy and a preacher sitting in front of her. And so anyway, they just hardly got that airplane off the ground. And that cowboy ordered a scotch and soda. Well, of course, you know, those flight attendants are so polite. And so pretty soon, she came back with his scotch and soda. And then she said, leaned over to the preacher, and she said, "Sir, would you like something to drink?" And he said, "Why?" He said, "I'd rather be hog-tied with a woman of ill repute than to let that alcohol touch my lips." And then the cowboy handed his drink back. He said, "I'll have the same thing that the preacher's having." He said, "I didn't know we had a choice."
Megan, we've watched you grow up, and we love you. And Rick, you're getting a wonderful, wonderful woman. So
we wish you well. And
yes. Lots of love, lots of happiness.
And God's blessings.
So it was announced that you win games all the time. And we know, Rick, if you buy the game, you don't win.
In combination with Nick's, yeah, well, it wasn't his copy of Dixit, so I guess that's why Rick won. Thanks for all of the Commodore 64 games growing up, though. That was great. And Police Quest, and all your other dad's games and stuff. That was great.
Aloha, Ricky and Megan. Oh, so wonderful to celebrate your special day here. And I hope that you will make many trips to Hawaii. God's blessings always.
Hi, Rick and Megan. Blessings.
We love you both. We can't wait for you to get your marriage life all started, all the plans and stuff, and hope we get to share in all of them. Blessings.
So, Megan, there's this joke that Rick wanted me to tell you. Some prisoners of war were captured by the Japanese, and they were made to work in the mines. And so, I forgot the joke. I gotta find the joke and tell you, but I'm not gonna tell you the punchline until we see you in Wisconsin. Love you, Megan. Enjoy basketball, and you gotta get Rick on the court, okay? Love you.
Now, we were forced into this, but quite honestly, we really do wish you the very best, and have a great life together. Love one another, love the Lord. That's what it takes. Go ahead.
And it was such a pleasure to be here. What a beautiful service, and really enjoyed our time here. I'm so glad we got to come, and it's a long drive, but that's okay.
Rick, Megan, you should be really happy you didn't get married in Wisconsin, because I've been to wedding receptions where the glorious couple did not have a chance to eat. It was all ringing of the glasses. So we're happy to come to Arkansas and give you an easy time of it.
I've been doing some mathematical calculations since my speech, and the chances of you guys having a wonderful...
Whoa. Don't ever tell them the odds. Oh. Don't ever tell them the odds. Oh, Megan and Rick, we have a good feeling about this. Congratulations.
Maid of Honor and the Best Man come up and make speeches. We're going to begin with our own Maid of Honor after she sings a brief medley of her favorite Broadway tunes. Not a chance. If I get a ballet move out of her, please welcome Laura Cox.
Could I dance instead of singing? About what I might say on this day when Megan gets married, and thought about what do I want people to know about Megan that they might not already know, and what Rick may or may not already know, but most of it you probably already know. We shared a room ever since I was born, and up until she moved out from college. And then that must have not been enough, because I moved back in with her when she bought her house and I graduated from college. And so from my mathematical calculations, I think that's 22 years that we've lived either in the same room or in the same house. So what I have concluded and what I would like to share with you guys after all that research is that she takes her roles in life seriously. And so what I mean by that is... Double meaning.
Yes.
I've heard her talk about wanting to be a really good aunt and taking as many adorable pictures of Hunter as she can whenever we visit. She always gets the best angle and shares them all with us. I've also heard her say how she wants to be a really good godmother to Ben, and she loves to pick out as much Lutheran and Star Wars stuff for him as possible. Done a good job at that. she also, I know, wants to be a good friend to all her friends. And she exchanges cute nephew pictures across the world with Chi, and she sets up Skype dates with her friends across the world. She keeps them in their prayers, whether they're all the way in another country or right here in Arkansas. She also puts up with her friends' dance parties. That happens spontaneously. Doesn't object too much. She also wants to be a good granddaughter and niece. I've heard her hashing out all her vacation days to make sure that she gets to visit and help with any puzzle needs that in California come up. And I know she wants to be a good daughter. You know, she hasn't wanted to stress anyone out too much with all the wedding planning. We all made it and survived. But most of all, I know firsthand that she took her job of being my big sister very seriously. She taught me all sorts of lessons, like it's important to be yourself and not just a copy of someone else. That with a keen eye for detail, one truth prevails. That whatever your interests are, you can use them to tell other people about God's love. And most famously, not to be afraid of the dark. Because when it's your time to go, it's your time to go. She's a realist. Played Barbies with me for much longer than I'm sure she probably wanted to. And she made them even cooler by making them use the Force and lightsabers. She was even so good at being a big sister that she stepped in and was a big sister to our amazing friend Lauren, too, when we were growing up. So I'm so thankful that God has assigned Megan to this role of being my big sister. And now I'm so thankful that God has given her a new role and joy of being your wife, Rick. And I can tell that you're a man that I am sure, beyond a shadow of a doubt, loves her very much and loves the Lord. And while I know that neither one of you will be perfect in your roles as husband and wife, no one is perfect. I know that God has promised to be with you, forgiving and strengthening you in your marriage and throughout your life. And he keeps his promises. So Rick, just in case you didn't already know, Megan's the type of person that will love you, be patient with you. Please be patient with her too. She will remind you that it doesn't always have to be about you. If you ever get cocky. Maybe that's just me. She will quote movies with you. She will give you an ice cream sandwich when you need it. She will keep you up on Japanese culture. You should still keep me up on Japanese culture. And she will mourn with you. She will rejoice with you. And she will pray for you. God has blessed you both with amazing, one-of-a-kind partners, and I'll be praying for you both as you take on these new, blessed roles as husband and wife. So, cheers to the bride and groom.
I feel like if I ran for office in this room, if I ran on the Luke Skywalker was a Lutheran platform, I'd win hands down. Next up, a few words from the best man, Wade Jackson.
Just a round of applause for Laura. That was an awesome speech. My fellow family, I'll be honest. If I put as much speech, as much time into my speech as Laura put into hers, it'd be much better. But, with that being said, I did a pretty good job of my over here.
Oh, good.
That's good. Okay, we're going with that then. So, a couple of things about Ricky that you may already know, maybe you don't know.
More?
More, right.
You might not know him.
Ricky is an enigma. Yeah. Wrapped in a paradox. Wrapped in a pun. In my mind, Ricky is three things. Orthodox, I'll explain that in a second, unorthodox, and selfless. Orthodox is meaning you hold to the strict religious traditions of your religion, in this case, Lutheran. Ricky is an extremely strong Lutheran, and that has really impacted my life, as well as the lives of those around him, which I think will make him an amazing faith leader of the household. So, that's awesome. I know that way back in the day, we had our favorite theology teacher, Mr. Pearson. And I can remember Ricky talking with Mr. Pearson and arguing with Mr. Pearson, and debating with Mr. Pearson. If you know Ricky, you know he's pretty good at these things. Maybe he learned them from Mr. Pearson. I also know that he's done a lot of good Bible studies with us. When Ricky and I were both single and we were both like looking for and waiting for that person to come, and I just remember him being there with us together and really, you know, being there with me as a brother at that time to say, okay, we're waiting, we're preparing ourselves, we can still learn more about God, develop ourselves, and through that, become the best husbands we can be. And with that, another one thing that really hit me was that, it's a story, that one time, Ricky was late picking me up from soccer practice. Ricky's never late normally, right? Maybe sometimes. Anyways, when he came, I was kind of angry with him. And so I was angry. He was coming through this one glass door, and I, in my anger, decided to put my foot against the door, and lo and behold, the glass shattered all over the place. And I thought to myself, one thing, let's book it. Let's get out of here. But Ricky said, no, wait, no. We're not going to do that. We're going to go, and we're going to go and talk to the principal's office and tell him what happened. And I was like, but we can go. There's no one here. But nonetheless, he and I went over to the principal's office and explained what happened. And they said that nobody had ever done that before. And they were just so impressed with the fact that someone was willing to go up and say, this is what we did wrong, hey, you know. And as a matter of fact, a big thanks to Dad in this case, helped paper the window. Thanks, Dad. And I learned a valuable lesson out of that. Oh, and the fact that Dad helps out a lot with kind of those kind of things. Then I learned that it's about doing what's right. And that's one thing I really learned about Ricky is that if you do it, you need to do it right. You need to do the right thing. And that kind of comes into the whole of Ricky's orthodoxy, wanting to do the right thing. He has a very strong drive to do the right thing. But of course, with that comes the fact that Ricky is very unorthodox, which is doing things in a non-conventional way, a not traditional way, such as tomato soup. I remember growing up, and if anyone that has ever had Ricky's cooking, you know it's unorthodox. An example of that, I'll give you two. One is that he used to like making tomato soup. And whenever Ricky made tomato soup, I would be in charge of making grilled cheese sandwiches, and he'd be in charge of making the soup. And it's really interesting. You think, like, Campbell's tomato soup would taste the same? It never did with Ricky. Never. He would always try something different. Balsamic vinegar, maybe putting some, don't worry, all right. There's no tomato soup being served tonight. Yeah. Don't worry about it. Especially known as apple cider vinegar. How about that one? I passed that one up. Stuck with the grilled cheese, and Ricky enjoyed that one all three times. All three servings of it. So, also, it was a great story of us making root beer milk together.
Oh, boy.
Who's ever had root beer milk, huh? Yeah. Oh, a couple. Yeah, there you go. You know how good it is. It's actually pretty good. I'll be honest. I remember the one time we made root beer milk with root beer milk extract, and all of a sudden there's just milk, root beer milk extract, and then sugar. We made it. I pull out this big thing full of what I thought was sugar, and put it in there, and it tasted like the most awful thing ever. Instead of like 3 cups of sugar for a gallon, it was like 3 cups of salt for a gallon. No, that didn't work out too well. But Ricky does have his bright spots. In this case, Megan, have Ricky make you ramen soup. He is so good at it. And I think that kind of comes along with the Japanese culture that he's so fond of, has learned so much about. As well as the fact that Ricky is not only unorthodox with cooking, but also unorthodox with games. He is unbeatable at board games. You may have already known this. Except maybe you're not unbeatable at board games yourself. Maybe you like to.
Depends on the game.
Yeah, depends on the game. So, and lastly, Ricky is selfless. Selfless. I remember that, I feel like all my life, Ricky's been someone that I felt like is a true friend to me, and that's so rare to have in your life. I know when I came to college, I followed Ricky to college, kind of like Laura followed you after college, I guess. And, Ricky became during college. Okay, good. Good. Okay, so I remember when I followed Ricky to college, I actually followed him around so much, I got the nickname of...
Not Rick.
Not Rick. So here I am, not Rick. But don't worry, I upgraded that name from being not Rick to being... Little Rick.
Little Rick.
Little Rick. Oh, that was great. That was great. Anyways, all I can say is, in college, Ricky was the person that... Whenever I needed someone to talk to, whenever I needed a group of friends to hang out with, Ricky was never like, these are my friends, and you can hang out with your own friends. He was always a person that was selfless to say, let's share. Let's share what we have. Let's enjoy friendship together. And that's why, like, when I think about my college days, the best friends I have I can think of, many of them are Ricky's friends, originally, that he shares with me, has to, gets to, whatever. And then I think with that, with Ricky being self, I think of him, where are we at today? What state are we in?
Arkansas.
Arkansas, right. Why are we in Arkansas? Because Ricky wants to live in Arkansas. How selfless is that? Oh, sorry. What I mean is, he left the great state of Wisconsin to come and live in Arkansas. Not that Arkansas is bad or anything. It's actually really good. I like this place. The chicken is really good. Thank you. So, with that, before I get booed off the stage, I will just say that I'll get a glass first. I am so thankful to have you as a brother. And I hope and pray and toast that you, Megan, will be even more thankful to have him as a husband.
touched it. She touched it.
Turn it around.
It's okay.
We just hold your hand in front.
We're about to cut into it. I
know. It's got my fingerprints all over it. It's really good.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're cutting the cake. With a knife.
So the middle one here? Okay. Right about here?
Let's do where there's no.
Right here?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yep.
Oh, that feeling right there.
Not
bad at all.
You know what? Is there a plate?
Well, we got everything except a plate.
No. Oh, they're right over there.
That butterfly is now gone. Welcome, little sliver.
Got it.
They touched it. 2 points off.
We're also going to take this butterfly.
Okay.
The cake has been cut!
Too much butterfly on that one. Gotta wash it down.
I love you.
I know.
Can I wipe my hands?
Thank you.
Drive and parking lot?
Park to the back, yes.
Okay. Shy, timid creature. Yay, it looks stunning. Yay, it's your big moment. Close up.
I want to talk to the guy with the camera again.
You know, it just doesn't go away. Look at you.
It's awesome.
You're up 3-2. Cards are up 3-2.
So the kids are outside. Thank you, Tim.
Hi. Hi, Brooke.
That's awesome, too.